What's up, guys? Jeremy Liu Photography. Thank you for tuning in again. Today is a little bit of a video about me and who I am, and a little bit about Hatch and my start in photography. I feel like I talk about this quite a bit, but usually in passing, and I don't know if it really reiterates to a lot of people and kind of sticks with them. So before we go on, please share, like, subscribe, join the channel, comment, ask questions. Let's make this a little more interactive, and then let people know about me. I'm here to help, and I'm here to share stuff. That's what I'm doing. So a little bit about me when I first started. I've been a photographer for about 7 years now, professionally, 7.5 years. We were having the birth of our second child, and my point and shoot broke. I went and purchased a camera. Instead of buying a really expensive point and shoot, which was my goal, I think I had like $400. So I was like, I'm gonna buy the best point and shoot that I can, and just grab a bunch of pictures of the baby coming out. I was talked into by the Best Buy employee to get a DSLR that can change lenses. Didn't know what that meant at the time, but it kind of rocked my world. So I went home and I started taking pictures of stuff around the house that night, just kind of playing with the camera. And they were coming out okay. You know, it felt like a point and shoot. And then I went on to Flickr.com, typed in the camera that I had. It was a Sony Alpha A300, which I thought was amazing. It's an okay camera. Now it's kind of like super crappy now I think about it. But for me, it was amazing at the time. So I went on Flickr, typed in A300. There's a little section where you can put the type of camera, the lenses that you use. And it shows all the pictures that were taken with that camera. And people were producing amazing pieces of art. So that kind of got the nerd and geek in me, and I learned how to shoot. I tried to get some help from other people. I contacted 5 photographers. Basically, they all, in one way or another, told me to drop dead. I was gonna kill the industry. I wasn't educated. And that's where kind of Reno was at the time. Not with everybody, of course, but most of Reno. I mean, I contacted 5, and they all told me to drop dead. So my ratio was kind of like all or none right there. So it kind of killed me a little, and I kind of stayed away from any photographer, and I had that mentality that photographers hated photographers. Why would I, share or work or do anything with other photographers? So I know for like a year while I was learning, I was really, really kind of down on other photographers. If I saw something on Facebook, block them, deleted them. Are they a photographer? Don't want to talk to them. And then as the year started to go by, I started to get a little more notoriety. I started building my clientele base a little bit. I quit my full-time job as a massage therapist and went full-time photography, which was one of the scariest things I've ever done, especially with the family. And I started having a few friends that were shooting as well. And they would ask me a few questions. I've always kind of been an educator background, whether it was with massage or schooling or anything, I was an educator. So when somebody asked me a question, my response was always yes. Even though I got the nose when I first started. So I started kind of hanging out with some photographers. We started doing some little photo walks with ourselves and kind of playing and learning and doing little tricks. I would learn stuff from them, they would learn stuff from me. We would get a couple models, do a little group shoot. Everything that kind of hatches now, but on a smaller scale. And it got fun, right? Photography was fun again. Yes, I had my clients on the side, but I was also doing all this other stuff on the other side, and I was building my passion as a photographer, which is super important. So years go by, like a year later, me and my friend Colin opened up our first studio. We called it Studio 205. It was Colin Nikolai Photography and Jeremy Liu Photography Within. I was using the studio maybe one day a week. He was probably using it 2, 3. He shot a little more in studio than I did. And what we noticed is we had some days that were open. So we started renting out the space by the hour to other local photographers who didn't have a studio. And it went great. We met a lot of cool photographers. They used the space. We even let use all the gear and equipment that was in the space. And so we started to build this little concept. A little bit after that, I kind of spewed away and was talking to other photographers about opening up a larger studio. These other photographers kind of wanted to do the co-op, which is like, you know, you all get a space, maybe a 2,000 square foot space, everybody gets 500 square feet, you pay the same amount, and you get your own little space, kind of like a cubicle, an office, something like that. It wasn't what I was thinking. I wanted to create, which hadn't been created yet, which is a membership-based photography studio, simple enough. It was really hard for me to kind of come up with this concept, or at least name it, where a photographer, my goal was newer photographers, amateur photographers, I thought could benefit off this the most, would pay a membership. And with that membership, they would be able to utilize everything within the studio, whether it's the sets, whether it's just a few lights, the backdrops, the viewing rooms, the workshop area, utilizing other photographers that had the same mentality. I wanted them to be able to connect, and for a fraction of the cost of a studio, right? So as of right now, Hatch is $150 a month max. With that, they get all the lights, all the gear, meeting rooms, workshop areas. They can bring their clients in anytime. It's 24/7 access. They book their studio time online. We have unlimited studio time for $150. If I had this when I was first starting, holy crap, like my career would have excelled. I would have saved a lot more money than buying shitty lights, throwing them away. But that was also my learning process. But you kind of get what I mean. So that's what we built. That's how I became into Hatch. So right now I have Jeremy Lou Photography and I have Hatch. And so within both of those, we're creating this amazing community over competition world right now. Over the past couple years of building Hatch, Hatch has been around for 2.5 years as of this video. We have had some haters, which we've kind of fought off or ignored. A lot of trolls, a lot of weird people coming in, checking us out just to kind of break us down. Which is kind of expected in kind of a newer industry. We never let it bother us. I always get a little personally offended because I feel like I'm doing this for the community or I'm helping out. I'm obviously not charging a rate to profit. I'm charging a rate to keep it going and to make it a little more valuable than free, right? Because you don't want to give anything for free, because if you give something for free, nobody really cares about it anymore. So we fought them off, and I think we've gotten a few on our side with what we're kind of doing. I'm not trying to reinvent the wheel. I'm not trying to take anybody's business away. But if I can help other photographers, especially the photographers charging $100, $200, $300 for a full portrait shoot with a USB of everything, if I can get their rates up to what I'm charging or to what the professionals are charging, then isn't that better for all of us? Isn't that better for somebody coming up to me for a wedding and say, hey, my name is Jeremy Liu. I start with $3,500 for a photographer. Oh, thank you, Jeremy Liu, but this person starts off at $500 for a photographer for the same thing you're offering. I'm not going to compete with that $500, but my job now is, instead of being mad at that $500 photographer who may not understand the value of what they do, why don't I help them rise up? Why don't I help them build up their craft and build up their pricing so that I'm not the jerk at $3,500 and now I'm not competing with them anymore? $3,500 to $500 is not competition anymore. The point of value is changing. If somebody's gonna hire a $500 photographer instead of a $3,500 photographer, it's basically because of price. It has nothing to do with the photographer. If I drop my price down to $500, they would hire me in an instant. That's not my client. So that's kind of my little thing on how Hatch became. I feel like I talk about this a lot, and this video would help a lot of people who don't really know me or haven't met me in person. But know that I keep talking about Hatch, and like, what's Hatch in all your videos? So check it out, hatchreno.com, membership-based photography studio. We have some really, really exciting things happening in the future, happening right now, but we can't really announce anything till it happens. So thank you guys so much for tuning in. Please share, like, subscribe, comment below. Any positive feedback would be amazing. If you have negative feedback, you can put it on, but you know, we just won't get any responses, especially if it's with Hatch and us trying to build the community and helping out. You're gonna look petty.